The Pakistan Air Force was in for their second surprise of the year 2019 on the 8th of October. On the occasion of India's Air Force Day, the flypast included the Avenger Sukhoi Su-30 MKI aircraft that the Pakistan Air Force had claimed they had shot down in February 2019. After losing an F-16 to a missile fired by Wing Commander Abhinandan in an Indian Air Force MiG-21, the PAF initially claimed that no F-16s had been used in their aborted raid across the border. This bluff was called with the finding of the debris of an AIM-120C AMRAAM missile in a village in India, 50 kilometers from the line of control and about 90 kilometers from Mirpur in Pakistan, above which a lot of air action had taken place on the 27th of February 2019. The Pakistan story then changed retrospectively to the absurd claim that an IAF Su-30 MKI had been shot down. Pakistan Air Force F-16s are known to have fired off at least 5 deadly AMRAAMs on that day in a desperate but failed attempt to score a propaganda victory by getting an IAF Su-30. So how did Indian Air Force Sukhois evade Pakistani AMRAAM missiles? Let us look at some of the known features of the generic AMRAAM missile. It has a dual pulse motor, which means that the rocket motor has an early boost phase that quickly accelerates the missile, followed by a sustained burn to keep up the speed. The actual number of seconds that the rocket burns is classified, but open source information suggests a surprisingly short burn time with a boost phase of 10 seconds to get a speed of about Mach 4 and a sustained phase of 15 seconds until the motor burns out. After that, the missile coasts without power, slowing down gradually. It is claimed to reach 100 kilometers, and we can be sure that it can reach more than 50 kilometers based on the location of the Pakistani missile debris in India. The missile has inertial guidance to take it in the general direction of the target, and it can receive updates from the launching aircraft or an AWACS. When it gets close to a target, the missile has its own radar to guide it to hit the target. Even if the missile's radar is jammed, it can home in towards the source of the jamming signal. In Pakistan, only the F-16 can carry and fire AMRAAM missiles. Using this basic information, we can guess how our Su-30s evaded the barrage of AMRAAMs fired off by the Pakistan Air Force F-16s. Up to 30 kilometers from the launch point of an AMRAAM is the zone where the missile flies under power, and this is sometimes called the no escape zone because the missile has the speed and power to hit a target that is so close, and the target aircraft has only 15 to 20 seconds to react and evade the threat. Still, a 100% hit is not guaranteed. From 30 to about 60 kilometers is a danger zone, because although the missile fuel has burned out, it is still flying very fast, and even at 60 kilometers it may be flying at Mach 2. But if the missile is forced to turn to follow a target aircraft, it will lose energy and slow down, increasing the chances for the target aircraft to escape. In these zones, the target aircraft can use several methods to avoid being hit by the missile, provided the missile launch has been detected or if the pilot of the target aircraft detects the radar signals painting him. Chaff and flares can be released to confuse and divert the tracking missile. The first evasive maneuver might be to turn so that the incoming missile is exactly to the right or the left of the targeted aircraft. Doppler ranging used by the missile to track the aircraft works best when the aircraft is moving away or towards the missile. If the distance remains constant, as would happen in this attitude, the tracking could be made to fail. Another possibility would be to jam the missile or the targeting radar, but the missile could home in on the jamming signals. Intense maneuvering could break the radar lock and let the missile pass by harmlessly. Hard, high G turns sometimes cannot be matched by a very fast-flying missile, which may not be able to execute the extra high G turn to keep tracking the target aircraft. At about 50 to 60 seconds after launch, the missile has gone beyond 60 kilometers. From here on, the target aircraft has a good chance of evading the incoming missile. He may break the lock by turning away, but even otherwise, he may be able to accelerate away and go out of range of the missile. There exists a very clear image of a Pakistani aircraft turning away after a missile launch to avoid being hit by an Indian aircraft. This also shows that the PAF were enthusiastically staying far away from Indian fighters, staying within Pakistani airspace while taking ineffective pot shots with missiles costing 35 crore each at our Su-30s. No risk, no reward, which is why Wing Commander Abhinandan Vartaman closed in and shot a fox in its own lair. Jai Hind! If you like this video, please subscribe and share. Thanks for watching.